Do subscribe to Ikeda channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSE and IIT JEE main and advanced videos.
Hello friends, now we are going to solve the second numerical of Hess law, and this Hess law that we have did in our earlier lecture also. So now let us do the second numerical of it. So friends, this is the equation that we have to do, and we have to calculate what would be the standard enthalpy of this reaction, that is when H2B4O7 plus H2O, it will give us 4 times of HBO2. So this is the thing that we have to calculate, and for that reference we have this three reactions that are in front of you, but the three reactions are been different, and we have to arrange them in such a manner that the overall reaction should be this, as well as with the help of the Hess law, we could easily calculate what would be the heat of formation or what would be the change in enthalpy we will observe while this transformation is being concerned. So for that, we have the first reaction that we have, that is 2 times of H3BO3 plus B2O3. It gives us 3 times of H2, and in that process basically the change in enthalpy, it has been calculated as 14.4 kilojoule. By that of the other one, it is basically H3BO3 plus HBO2 plus H2, as you could see. So in this process basically minus 0.02 is the enthalpy change that we are observing, and at the last step that they have given to us is H3B4O7, in which after the reaction it gives us 2 times of B2O3 plus H2O, and in this case the change in enthalpy that has been calculated is, it has been found to be 17.3 kilojoule. So by the fact of this three reactions that have been provided to us, and with the help of this thing we have to calculate the main reaction, that is the reaction whose enthalpy of the reaction is not known to us. So let us go with the first reactant and let us write it in a step by step so as we could calculate it in a very easy manner. So the first reactant that we have is H2B4O7. It is being reacted with H2O, as well as we are getting 4 times of HBO2. So with this reference, let us see whether and where the H2BO4 is being present. So the H2BO4O7 is being present in the third reference reaction, that is being given as H2BO4O7, and it gives us 2 times of B2O3 plus H2O. So this process, since we need only one mole of H2B4O7, so that's the reason in step number 3, as we could see as a reference reaction, the number of moles of the H2B4O7 is nothing but 1 mole itself. So we'll consider this reaction, and we will not multiply this by any number with this, because if we have to multiply this with a number, then overall the reaction will also will have a change. The stoichiometry of the reactant and the product will also change along with that of the enthalpy of that particular reaction. So because we need only 1 mole of H2B4O7, so therefore the reaction that has been given to us, it is very much fair, and we don't have to do any kind of disturbance, or we don't have to multiply a bit by any number. So I'll keep this reference and I will make this as equation 1 so that it would be very much helpful for me. So now let the equation 3 will be as equation 1. So therefore we have, that is H2B4O7, that is giving us basically 2 moles of B2O3 plus H2O. And in that process basically the change in enthalpy that has been calculated, or that has been found, it was found to be basically 17.3 kilojoule. So this is what we have, as well as we will also mention the physical states of that, that is solid in this case, again solid, and this is the liquid state. But this is the equation that I need, and it would be very much helpful for me, so therefore I will make it as equation number 1. So let us move on to the, so this is confirmed. So out of the three reference reaction that are that has been given to us, I have manipulated that reaction, and among three only two are remaining, and we have to discuss on that. So let us see how can we manipulate, or how can we do the algebraic sum in that, or multiplication of any kind of number in that, so as to do injustice to calculate how can we calculate the enthalpy of the reaction that is to be calculated as well as the reaction should also be matched with the reaction that has been given to us, or of which we have to calculate the enthalpy of reaction. So let us move towards the second one. So in this case, what we are observing is H3BO3 and that is giving us HBO2 plus H2. But in the reaction that we have to calculate the standard enthalpy, we could see that the HBO2 has been present 4 times, while in this case, as you could see, it has been present only 1 time in the product side. So the thing that we have to do is we have to multiply by 4 in the equation number 2 or the reference section 2, so as to convert this product to be 4 times of HBO2. So now what I am going to do, I will consider this, that is equation 2 that they have given to us, or I would say the reference, second reference section that has been given to us, and I will manipulate it by multiplying it by 4. So we will multiply 4 with the reaction that we have as reaction number 2. So let us see what is the thing that we could observe. We have basically H3BO3 that is giving us HBO2 and plus H2O, and the delta H naught for this reaction has been given to be minus 0.02 kilojoule. But since we have said we have to multiply it by 4, so what we are going to do, we'll multiply this number with we'll make the stoichiometry into 4 times H3BO3 plus 4 times of HBO2, and again it will give me 4 times of H2O. Then what will happen to the enthalpy of the reaction? Yes, it will be also be multiplied by 4. So therefore, if it is been multiplied by 4, then the answer that we could get is basically minus 0.08 kilojoule. So this is what I needed. This is what I needed on the reactant side, while this is what I needed on the product side. So these are the two reactions that I have mentioned in this case. So this is how I have manipulated. So the third equation is also been remaining, or the first reference reaction is also been remaining. So let us concern that also, and let us see what kind of change that we could do in that reaction. So let us learn about that also. And this is the reaction. So in this case, basically 2 times of H3BO3 is giving us B2O3 plus 3 times of H2O. And moreover, thing that we should know that this B2O3 is not something which we require, and as well as this B2O3 is present on the right hand side, or we could say it as product. But we have finalized the equation number 3, the reference reaction 3, as equation number 1, and we could see that there are 2 moles of B2O3. So what I am going to do is, because this B2O3 is not needed to me, so what I will manipulate it as, I will shift, or I will reverse this reaction, so that, and I will multiply it by 2 so as to cancel out this 2, that is B2O3 molecules that are present on the left hand side, on the right hand side. So this will make a quite more tedious work to do. So let us do that also. So the plan is to multiply it by 2 as well as to reverse it. So what I am going to do is, multiplying reaction 1 that we have by 2 and reversing it. So let me go with the ordinary step, that is the first step that we are going to do. That is, first thing that we are going to do is we'll multiply it by 2, and then let us see that what will happen if we reverse the process. So the reaction that we have as a reference is 2 times H3BO3 that is multiplied by that is giving us B2O3 plus 3 times H2, and this is the value of delta H. So let me multiply this by 2 and let us see what is we would get. So first of all, we'll multiply the reaction one that we have by 2. So for that, what we'll get? We'll get basically 4 times of that is H3BO3. And that should give us, because I'm multiplying it by 2. So in this case, as you could see, I'll multiply this by 2 as well as this also by 2. As well as this will be also be multiplied by 2. That is the enthalpy of the reaction will also be multiplied by 2. So in this case, what will I would get? That is 2 times of P2O3 plus 6 times of H2O. And in this case, the delta H not that we have get that we have will also be multiplied by 2. So in this case, we have basically 14.4 kilojoule that will be multiplied by 2. So this is what we get. But we have also mentioned that we have to reverse the reaction. So in this case, what will happen is we will reverse the reaction by forming after reversing. So this is where we have only multiplied by 2 and now we are reversing that. So therefore, this will give us 2 times of B2O3 plus 6 times of H2O. That should give us 4 times of H3BO3. And in this case, the delta H naught will be the reverse of what we have. So we have a positive value, that is 14.4 into 2. But if we'll reverse it, so the magnitude will remain the same, but the thing is the sign will be different compared to that of the earlier one. So now it will be minus. So if I have multiplied this by 2, so therefore it will give us an answer of something around 28.4 kilojoule. And this was my plan. So I'll make this equation to be equation number 3. So now what we have is we have equation number 1, 2 and 3, and because of which we can calculate what would be the delta H for the reaction that they have provided us to calculate the enthalpy of reaction. So the thing is, now let us equate it and let us see whether we have gone in a right direction or not, whether we could get the required equation or not by doing simultaneous equation of equation 1, 2 and 3. So let us do that also. So now what I'm going to do is equating 1, 2 and 3. It's just like algebra that we have did. So let me do that also. So the equation number 1 that we have got, it was H2B4O7 that had given us 2 times of B2O3 plus H2O, as well as this will also remain the same. So in this case, what will happen, I am going to write it as yes, H2B4O7 that has given us 2 times of B2O3 plus H2O, and the delta H, which was found to be 17.3 kilojoule, but I will name it as H2 just for a reference, because in Hessler also that we have studied that delta H1 is equals to H2 plus H3 plus H4, and it will go on continuing up. It depends on the number of step of the reaction that it has undergone through. So in this case, the first is been done, and let us move on to the second one that we have is, that is 4 times of H3BO3, and that is giving us basically 4 times of HBO2 plus 4 times of H2O. So this is what we have got, and in this case the delta H naught, and I will name it as 3, it was found to be somewhere around minus 0.08 kilojoule. And moving to the last one, the last equation that we have, or that we have made it, and it was found to be somewhere around 2 times of B2O3 plus 6 times of H2O, and that is giving us 4 times of H3BO3. And in this case, the delta H naught, it was found to be, I will limit as 4, it was found to be around minus 28.4 kilojoule. So this is the thing that we have manipulated. But the thing is, let us check whether we are going in a right direction or whether the reaction, whether we could get the required reaction or not. So if I do a simultaneous equation in this process, like in algebra, so I could clearly see that this B2O3 and this B2O3, they are present on the right hand side and left hand side, as you could see. So this will cancel out each other. So that is what I have cancelled out each other. And I could see that this four times of H3BO3 and this four times of H3BO3, they are present in the opposite side. That is, one is present on the reactant end while the other one is present on the product side. Even they will cancel out each other. And the much more concerned thing which has been left with us is H2B407, that has been left with us. As well as we could see that the H2O that is present on the left hand side is six times, or six moles of H2O is present on the left hand side. While that of on the right hand side, if you would observe that 4 H2O plus 1 H2O, that means 5 moles of H2O that are been present on the right hand side. So in this case, basically, 6 out of 6, 5 will be cancelled out from the left hand side, and 5 will be cancelled out from the right hand side. Then the only thing that has been left on the left hand side or the reactant side is H2B407 plus among 5, only one has been remaining. Out of 6, only one is remaining. So that for this makes 1 times H2O. And talking about the next one, that is here we have the equation that has been left with us is 4 times of HBO2. And yes, this is the thing that we have left, and even H2O has been cancelled out with this one. So this is the reaction that we have, and let us see whether the reaction is similar to that of the required or not. This is the reaction, while this is the same reaction that we have to calculate. So that means we have went in a right direction and we have manipulated the numericals very carefully and very precisely. So it will be very much easy to calculate the sum of this thing. So therefore, the delta H would be very much easy to calculate. So we'll sum up all this thing, that is the delta H of delta H2 plus delta H3, or enthalpy of reaction 2, reaction 3, 4 that we have right now with us. And let us do what is the answer. So the answer that we have got is minus 11.18 kilojoule. So this is the change in enthalpy that we have observed when H2B407 reacts with H2O so as to form 4 times of HBO2. So this is how we have calculated a enthalpy of a reaction whose enthalpy of a reaction cannot be calculated, suppose experimentally, or we could analyze this by using Hess law also. It was a very much simple sum. So this kind of numericals are very simple, but the only thing is we have to know how to manipulate those reaction and how to calculate this thing. It's a very easy process to calculate. I hope you are going to try to do more numericals based on this kind of equations, and you will apply Hess law on that also. So yes, thank you friends for watching this video. I hope you have liked this video and you will share this video with your friends. And yes, don't forget to share this video with your friends, family. Don't forget to subscribe to Egra channel. Thank you so much.